Hey guys, what's going on? Magic here, and I'm gonna play a little game called Bastion. This is a game I stumbled upon maybe about a month ago or so on the Xbox Live Arcade Network thing, whatever you wanna call it. It's an arcade game, and it's an indie game. Let's just jump right in while I'm talking. This game is amazing. So, it's, like I said, it's an indie game. It was made by like one random developer, I think, and it took him a good while to make it. But this game is incredible. It's a short game, because it's an arcade game, but I think it came out in 2011. But this game is just, it's well made, it's fun to play, the storyline is just interesting, the music is great. One quick thing I want to say about the game before we jump into it, I've already played it, I beat it already, so I'm going to start a new game. But this whole game is narrated. So, like, I do commentary videos, and I play and I commentate over it. This whole game is commentated, pretty much. The whole story, every little thing you do, pretty much, is narrated. So, I'm going to try my hardest. I'm going to record this game because I love it. It's a great game. And I'm not a professional at this game by any means, but I'm going to do my best. It's a great game. I wanted to share it on my channel, whether a lot of people watch it or not. I wanted to share this game because I thought it was well made. It's one of the best games I've played, and it was so low key. But it is narrated. I will try to commentate when I can. And fair warning, I may talk over the narrator a little bit. Like, it's gonna happen because this whole game is talking. So I have subtitles on. Please don't yell at me if I talk over him. He has a very nice voice. Not as nice as Morgan Freeman, but he's up there. So, we're just going to jump into it because I'm starting to ramble. And, yeah. What is this? Start a game with unlimited chances now. New game plus. Start a game with all structures, spirits, idols unlocked, plus all weapons. No. If this game does really well, or this series does really well, I might go back to score attack mode, where you start with all the stuff, and I can make... It's pretty much a harder system. It'd be like a new game plus on a harder difficulty, but anyway, let's do this. Yes. And like I said, I may talk over the, I'll try not to talk over the narrative too much, but it's bound to happen. I apologize for that. Please don't yell at me.
Proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted. Leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky.
So, we're in the game already. I'm asleep. Once I hit a button, I'm gonna wake up.
He gets up. Sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as it points the way. He don't stop to wonder why.
So this is how, like, the whole game is structured. As you walk, the level gets built, pretty much. And this is kind of... I guess in a way a post-apocalyptic game, but they call it the Calamity instead of the Apocalypse. But it's pretty much the same thing from what I've understood. It's a really
finds
interesting
his
game.
Lifelong friend just lying in the room.
And you get
well,
so many weapons.
Touching reunion.
So many weapons, ranged weapons, melee weapons. I'm pretty much gonna stick to, once I can get rid of this hammer, I'm probably never gonna use it again. There's like a little machete you get. You get it relatively at the beginning of the game. But once I get that thing, to me, that was my favorite weapon. I keep it. Like, I'll keep
he
it the whole game.
He sees what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. In the Calamity.
And in each level, almost every level, you get a new weapon. And I'll use that weapon for the remainder of the level. But then I may not use it too much after. Just letting you guys know. You'll see every weapon used, but... I probably won't use it.
That a survivor?
A lot.
No, ma'am. It's a gas fella, forced out from underground.
All right, so I'm gonna kill this guy. Woo! Okay.
Kid pops him good. Fella got a piece of him though.
So you really just get to destroy stuff, and like, the narration changes based off what you're doing. So if I just start beating crap up, like just everything, he'll say something.
Kid just rages for a while.
See, if I just stand here, I believe he'll say something too, but I'm not going to just
an
stand.
An old repeater falls out of the sky. Ain't
so this is our first ranged weapon.
But it'll have to do.
Kind of like a machine gun? Not really. I mean, it's a quick gun. I don't use this one for too long either. It's an interesting weapon, but there's a better ranged weapon later in the game. It's like a shotgun, pretty much, and I use that for the rest of the game too.
You've worked up quite a thirst by now, so that fountain looks real inviting. Sometimes you just need a drink.
Then this game's not that hard. Towards the end, they throw a lot of enemies at you at once.
Tunnels up around them. Must have fled here from the mines.
But it's not that difficult. Oops. But yeah, this game is it's just extremely interesting. So I can go in there. I can go over here. There's probably some bonus stuff laying around.
Kid finds a memento from a girl he knew. Always used to fancier.
Just beat the crap out of people. It's pretty much it's kind of like a hack and slash game. Or at least that's what I would categorize it as. And of course you level up and you get to like customize your character and stuff a little bit. Not too in depth, and it's not complicated whatsoever, but it's interesting.
He sets foot inside one of Celandia's famous watering holes.
And just the way that
Rondi, the bartender,
the way that this game is
the calamity got him for the drinking
like progresses, the way it's told, it's interesting. It's not complicated by any means, but it's a very interesting game.
Then Kid finds his trusty shield.
And the shield is freaking awesome. You walk really slow when you pull it out, but there's a level up you can get relatively early that lets you walk quicker. Thief.
Clang. Shield saves his hide.
The thing about the shield is you can hold it up and it deflects like any attack. See, like he gets stunned for a while. But if I hit the shield button right when they're about to attack, it does a counter and it does like a lot of damage.
Up for last call.
Let me see if I can try to do one. There. See, I just killed him. Counter, counter, counter. Counter. Okay. I should stop counting.
More squirts start coming out of the woodwork.
Oh, and you'll see me rolling a lot in this game. Rolling, you just move quicker when you roll. I don't know if there's a level up
big old fella
that makes you move quicker. I'm not too sure about that. Oh my god. Forget how tough these guys are at the beginning of the game. Come on. Boom! Counterattack. And like leveling up takes forever in this game. I think the first level up comes at the end of this level, just
it's a bit of a drop.
For the sake of teaching you. But by the end of the game, and I did pretty much everything in this game. By the end of the game,
they always wanted his ashes scattered here.
I killed the guy. By the end of the game, I was like level 5. And I think you can, the max level you can be is like maybe 10 or 15. I don't know. Like, it's definitely not 5. You'll see the level up system in a bit when it happens. And yeah, I'll show you. But I was like level 4 or 5 at the end of the game, which obviously is not a big number, which shows you that the game's not that long.
He gets a
but
good look at things.
It takes forever to level
down.
Up. And I fall
he
from
lands
the sky.
On top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke.
Okay, this bow is pretty awesome. I'm again just use it until I get that shotgun, but it's a pretty awesome bow.
Kid spies a good perch for some target practice.
Alright, let's do this.
He knows he should draw the string all the way back. Wasn't long before the kid could loose an arrow, strong and true.
There we go. So if you hold it all the way, you know it's obviously charged up, and you would think holding it all the way would make it the strongest, but if you notice I start blinking or I flash like that, if you let it go and you flash like that, it's called a power shot, and it does like
the kid pockets a
bonus damage
from a breaker. Once the fastest man in the land.
So, and that's with like every ranged weapon in the game, so when you see the glow, boom, power shot
right back at you.
Let me see. Good
news is the emergency defenses
power shot
work.
Bad and it does a lot of damage. 32 damage at the beginning of this game is a lot. That was 34. And see that? I didn't use a power shot there and it gave me 28. So still powerful, but not as powerful.
Picks up a few pointers from a dusty old tome.
And then what I just picked up was like a special attack. So the special attack I picked up was for the hammer. So it makes me do like a spinning attack. And that's what these little black tonic bottles, that's what it's for. Oh, and also this bow, like, it goes through the enemy, so I can kill, like, 2, 3, 4 enemies at once. Pretty interesting. Oh, oh! Okay. Like I said, I'm not that great at this game. I'm not, like, the best at all.
You find the distillery right next to the arsenal.
So the distillery is the level up area.
One sip of the spirits in that distillery, and the kid will
feel like a new man. So I'm level 1. See, right now, you have 10 levels available, and you can upgrade the place later, and it may... I don't remember if it unlocks 5 more or not, so the... For sure, you can get hit level 10, possibly level 15. And I only hit, I think, 4 or 5, so I was only up here. So what you do is you go here, and there's, like, drinks, and they do different things. So this one is plus 10 max health, which is a lot of health. This is plus 10 critical hit chance only when I'm at full health, which I've never used. And then this one absorbs stray fragments, which I never use. So this is the first one. Gives me health, max health for the rest of the game. So that's awesome. And then the arsenal
is where the kid can pick the best tools for the job.
If I didn't want the bow, I could use the repeater. This is the B slot and this is the X slot, so I could put the hammer in the X slot if I wanted, but I'll just leave it there. And then this is a different, what were they called? I don't remember what they called it, but, like special attacks pretty much. So this is the whirlwind one I just picked up, or I can use the dancing shot for the bow. So let's use the bow one. A secret skill, that's what it's called. Okay. So this is what this secret skill will look like. Boom! I just killed all of them. That's cool. I've never used that one, actually.
Some of them squirts, birthing like crazy in a couple of corn bins.
Alright, so these little things, this little, like, cart-looking thing, it's like a spawner for those enemies, so... Obviously bust that. Quit frickin' spawning.